Do you do any of the kind of live performance turntable stuff like Rob Smith does?
No. The thing is that I like very different kinds of music. So it's not hip hop really, it's not jazz. It's a lot of different things. I'm into electronic music, house music
It's
maybe.
Alexander's mine.
Sorry?
It's Alexander's mine. Yeah.
Yeah, that's it. That's
And
it.
how? And do you have pretty much free rein with your choices? And do you enjoy the creative freedom of being able to choose whatever you want?
You know what? I can understand how it is for a musician because even if you work in a bar or in a club, you still got your restrictions. You're still restricted as to how extreme you can be. You know?
Yeah,
You
so you
know,
understand our dilemma.
yeah, I mean, I play some frightening stuff, and sometimes I'm not able to do that. It depends who's
I
there.
understand. But you have to have a good instinct about when sometimes that frightening stuff would be great and people would love it, but it has
Yeah,
to be the right audience.
exactly. Yeah, you got to feel it. I've got two
So
more questions. Go ahead.
yes.
Go ahead.
Well, I was just going to say that we had so many discussions about the problem of being commercial as a professional and compromising your artistry or whatever. But ultimately, I believe almost all of us who are in the arts are communicators, and we have our vision that we are with our listeners or our viewers or whatever. And it's a two-way thing that to some degree, at least, we have a responsibility to inspire our listeners and to be influenced by that. I don't believe any artist lives totally in a vacuum. I don't believe in snobbery in the way of just ignoring
People.
how my listeners react to it. So I think there's an interaction that's very healthy that has to place. And the only time I have a problem with it is when the audience starts to drive the train rather than the artist. So that when the cart gets before the horse, and when the artist is changing only because of their belief that the art they're on a dangerous, what I call a fishing trip, because you're trying to figure out what that audience is going to like, and you may be wrong. That audience might like what you feel passionately better than how they will feel about it if you try to do it their way. And it's a hard lesson to learn. It's a hard thing to stay on the right side of being faithful to yourself first, but also to have a sensitivity to the people that you're doing it.
I think it's kind of in another way, it's also kind of impossible to have that interaction because it's inhuman. Even animals, even the most basic animals, yeah, they feel each other, you know, that's how they get their prey.
Sure.
Not just
Yeah,
saying that,
sure.
not just saying that musicians prey on their own cart, but also as you said, the cart. If the cart is going to complain, then let the cart make the music.
Yes,
If
exactly right.
he's going to
Let them
complain,
try it to see
let
how
him
easy
try
it
it.
is.
Yeah, take an instrument and do it yourself.
Yeah, well, that's a great thing to say to critics because critics can sometimes be very brutal in their indictment of music. But if you get indicted in a bad way, and if you get a bad review by a critic, and I've had my
I can
share of
imagine,
those, one of the first things that comes to my mind is, okay, you sit down and try to do that. See how good you are at it. See how easy you think it is.
It's not so easy, is
Whatever,
it?
but it is very tempting to tell people that it's easy to be a critic, but it's much harder to be the person who's putting themselves out there with their passion and their life.
Personal things. Yeah.